And welcome back to Pillars of Eternity. I am the RPG chick. We're about to enter the Temple of Woedica.
Got it.
People. Mercenary. I don't understand all this secret handshake business, but it pays. I love this theme. Did they send you to check out on that nervous kid in the library? One of the other men swears there's a secret treasure chamber down here. Cool. Heading straight for the salty mast once we're done here. Yeah, we might have found the secret treasure chamber over here. There's a hidden stone or something this way. There's a couple traps in here, so just watch out. I knew it was there and blundered into it anyway. It only caused us 3 damage, though. Might have been lucky in that regard. Another mercenary. Not a whole lot of excitement so far, but at least it's easy coin. Can I just take that? They're not attacking me, so I guess so. Alright, let's go this way. Loving the game. Misplaying it. Well, I was waiting for my headset to come back. Repairs and such were being replaced. A bunch of more mercenaries. And a door. And another urn. The acolyte's crankier than usual. One of her masked friends got lost in the sewers, it seems. Maybe it's one of the bodies we found. Oh, I can't read that. Whoops. I'm trying to. My eye itches, man. Alright. Primal rock. A chiseled portion of rock, slate gray and pocked with gleaming minerals. When set on the ground, it floats a small distance above the earth. Could you imagine if you had one of these things in real life? A floating rock. And binding copper. These tight coils of gleaming copper are typically found in conjunction with Adra, I forgot how to say it, where they affect peculiar changes. Huh. Electricity of some kind? I guess we could just take the stuff, even though we're not masked and we haven't given a secret handshake. Is there any monsters hanging around here? Ooh. Aloth falters and brings a hand to his forehead. He takes a staggering step forward, coughing and sputtering. Aloth?
Back, you Claude! Those hooded fiends are nigh to be trusted!
Aloth, you don't talk like that. Since when were you Scottish? Adair says, Aloth, hey, now's not the best time for... that. He grimaces, catching his breath. It's nothing. I'm fine. This probably isn't the best place to linger, anyhow. Aloth, what the hell's into you?
How may I help?
Leaden key agents. What's going on with Aloth? I can't even ask him about this. Huh? I thought we were like walking into poison or something. What the hell?
Got it.
Peridot and 298 copper pans.
Yeah.
Well, we are going to explore down here, so keep your Scottish guy. I don't remember the hood and mask. You hear murmurs and chants on the other side of this door. A ritual of some sort is already underway. So we can don the hooded mask, or beckon the party to follow you. Go into the chamber alone. How about don the hooded mask? You pull the hooded mask over your head. They're uncomfortable, but they seem to hide your face. Oh, excuse me, guys. I don't know. Refresh my memory. When do we find the hooded mask? Was it given to us at the beginning of this quest? I mean, it's probably happened many, many videos ago, because I don't even remember. I don't want to go in alone. I fear that might be a mistake. But shouldn't we all have a hooded mask? Let's just all go in and see what happens. These are my allies, and they want to join the order. Please give them a hooded mask and stuff like that. You open the door and stride into the chamber, motioning for the rest of your party to accompany you. I wonder what's down that other way, though. We haven't gone that way. Got to remember that. So there's a shrouded woman. Several shrouded figures are lined up across from a hooded woman. The figure at the head of the line approaches her, and the woman places her outstretched hand on the stranger's forehead. They stand in silent communion as you look up. A few moments later, the stranger steps aside and resumes his place in the circle around the statue. Oh, crap. The hooded woman looks past you to your party. The other figures do the same, muttering among themselves. The woman points a long finger at you. Stop them. You're telling me to stop them? Stop nothing. Shrouded woman. Anyone special here? Just little shrouded people. Bunch of interesting things to look at if we survive this encounter. Alright. Well, start right off the bat here. Amplified thrust off of Adair. Why is Aeloth in front? Damn it. Well, he'll attack from range. Let's go for the woman first, I guess. Knock down on the woman. He can't cast that yet. In a second he can, so I'll just have him stand there for a sec. Attack. Attack.
Yeah.
Now we'll put that on. Head back a little. Well, I'm trying to pause and I'm unpausing. Soul Shock. Off of a dare. Oh, there's someone on him. Who's this? Canna? Come around. Hit that guy. Oh, why do you have your arquebus out? Do we have all range weapons? No. Oh, it's only him, because he couldn't... I couldn't get him around the door in the last combat, so I had him with ranged. Throw a minor heal. Mostly for Aeloth's benefit. Actually, she's right by the shrouded man, so hit him. She's sickened and frightened and dazed. No wonder she's not reacting. Okay. This could be bad. Can't let him go. Can't make him go yet. I know he has at least one spell to counter. I the sickened effects. Prayer against infirmity. A bonus against attacks, reducing the duration of such affliction. Suppress affliction. Oh, cool. This suspends status effects. For only 11 and a half seconds? That's not very long. We might have an upgrade and a tier 3 here. See, that's good for all defenses, but they already have the affliction, so I want to take away the affliction as much as possible. Nighting Doubt, Dire Blessing. Pillar of Faith is pretty cool. But I usually just have him buffing and healing. There we go. Yeah, that's with hobbled or stuck afflictions. Warding Seal. Now you know what it is? Where was it? Sorry guys, I forget. Prayer against infirmity. Well, I gotta wait for his spell to negate first. Now he's being attacked, brother. Can he just... He's gonna get hit just by doing that. Light endurance. Okay. Knockdown. Where is he? There. Knock her the hell down. Kano, you're already hitting him, I guess, right? Aeloth now is free to go, I think. We're all... Bounding missiles here. Hit her and it'll bounce off to somebody else. Zoom in a little here.
Lava will be on.
Oh, someone else is hitting him now. At least he got to go. Paladin is getting hit. He's throwing it. Damn, can you get off Aeloth? Soul Shock off of Adair again. If we get rid of... We got rid of her, didn't we? Hit him. Knock him down. Palagina got knocked down. Oh, she's prone for another 7.3 seconds. Now, what about this spell? Reduce the duration. Get everybody. That might help. What else do I like? Pillar of Faith? Pillar of Faith, why not? Okay, Theodis is out. Where is she, by the way? So Theodis, hit that guy. Aloth, you might as well just hit that guy normally. Have yet to go. Yeah. Knock down in the sky. Boom. Did I get rid of one? I can't tell with all the effects. You still haven't even used one. Kill him. Good. Now I can use it on him. Durance, you might as well just hit him. I'm sure Aloth is getting hit. Aloth Crazes shouted, man. He hit him back there, but they're not hitting very hard. But we do need to help Palagina. Actually, Palagina, just lay hands on yourself. Yeah, he's out. Aloth is surrounded by enemies here. Divine Mark. On that guy. Ouch. Aloth's about to fall. Can you get off a bounding missile to this guy? He's annoying. Before you fall? Nope. I hope that wasn't his chunks. Don't let it be Aloth's chunks. Oh, why are you guys just sitting here doing nothing? What's this? That's pretty cool. Do we have bad stuff here? No, I don't see that we have any negative effects on us at the moment. So I think we're good. So just stop standing there and attack. Faux target. Yeah, mind blades. Mind blades, baby. Chunkage. More chunkage. And hello. How are you on this fine day? Not too good? I wonder why that is. Aeloth's getting up, right? Crumpled at your feet lies the body of a woman. She wears a dark robe that bears an insignia resembling a key. As you approach the woman's body, feelings of rage assault you. The dead woman's voice howls in your ears, and her lingering consciousness rends at yours. Her essence tingles through your bones and membranes. It fills the spaces between your ears and behind your eyes, clawing deeper into your core. You see a gathering of men and women wearing robes like hers, their face hidden behind masks. One by one they approach her, whom they know as an acolyte, and she places her hand on each of their foreheads, searching their thoughts. She tests them with ritualistic questions, and they answer that their oath is sealed by the leaden key. She asks them of their tasks. She gives them new ones, all without a word. Try to see the tasks. Her essence flares, fighting to boil your blood, burn your memory, and splinter your bones from within. That's nasty. Yet between its strikes you see flashes of something else. A tower, a prisoner, and a ruin. You funnel all of your concentration into a single effort of will, a sharp point that pins the raging soul in place like an insect in a display case. With the thing under control, you're able to examine it and the three thoughts swirling inside. I don't know which one's more important. Examine the thought about the tower. You see a palimpsest of a neighborhood. I am unfamiliar with that word. Run-down estates are cobbled around a cemetery and an ancient tower. Savage shapes prowl the streets, and in the tower a man hunches over a strange mechanism. You can't see him clearly, but there's something unnatural about him. Somewhere nearby you see a woman with a scar over her heart. You understand that she has something he needs. You also see a door in the base of the tower, seemingly impenetrable slab of stone and copper, but then the acolyte reveals the invisible split between the perfectly matched halves, and you understand how the copper veins convert a command into action. You know how to open the door. Inquire about the prisoner. In your mind, you see a building, magnificent with trellises and tiles and located on a pristine boulevard. The wealthy and learned scroll in and out, trading knowledge and coin. Yet it also houses misery and madness. Somewhere within its rotten core sits a man, his hair matted but his eyes alert. He watches and waits, a prisoner by choice. By choice. About the ruins. The Acolyte's vision takes you out of Defiance Bay into a town in the wilderness with a watermill. A signpost on one of the paths reads Deerford. Several figures huddle together, shrouded in cloaks and hoods. An image of ruins suddenly looms in your mind. Two skeletal effigies flank a cleft in the mountainside. Deerford. Isn't that across the river? Like north of here? Okay, he's at one. Good. Find the place of misery and madness. The leaden key has sent operatives to find the site, though their purpose is unknown to me. I don't know exactly where the ruins are, but perhaps someone in Deerfoot Village does. The ancient towers in a derelict district of Defiance Bay. Could that be Heritage Hill? Or Andra's Gift? The woman with the scar over her heart holds the key to whatever happened there. The leaden key was interested in this tower for some reason. I need to understand what it does if I'm to figure out their plans. An ancient town near a cemetery. In a neighborhood filled with rundown estates. I mean, I haven't been to Heritage Hill yet. Sounds like Heritage Hill. Asking around would be a place to start, perhaps among the patrolling justiciars who would know the city well. And the prisoner. A place of misery and madness. I need to find this agent, discover his or her plan to see if it holds any clues in finding the man I'm searching for. A wealthy neighborhood that also has misery and madness. Oh, it's got to be Brackenbury Estates. There's someone waiting there, a prisoner by choice. Seems like Brackenbury Estates. To Death's Gate. Oh, I've seen that. Quest completed. We're done? All the goodies. A fine great sword. Fine robe, plate armor. Woedica hood. A dark mask bearing the stylized countenance of Woedica is attached by thread to a black hood. Worn together, they obscure most of the defining features of the wearer's head. So we all could have put that on. Where's a key? A lead key covered in a dark blue-hued patina. Warhammer.
No problem.
Ooh, Novice's Grimoire. I haven't messed with the grimoires. I'll give it to Adair for now, because he's full. Oh no, he has one slot. Oh, he has two slots. We have that. Mirrored image. Binding web. Awesome. So we know the mirror image spell. That's just like from D&D. And that's web. Curse of Blackened Sight is a blindness spell. Combusting wounds. We have that. Bounding missiles. Lengrath's displaced image. Cause the caster to be visually displaced, increasing their deflection and reflex for the duration. Many hits for attacks against deflection and reflex will be converted to grazes. So you could swap spells back and forth between grimoires. We have quite a collection now, so... I'll have to experiment with that. Let's creep so we can find...
Quickly and quietly.
We can find hidden stuff. Let's look at this. Whether by design or by consequence of the sputtering candlelight, the hooded statue's face is almost impossible to see. Devotees have placed assorted keys, their teeth filed away among the tunnels, runnels actually, of wax. 21 gold. What's that? Is that something? Is that a thing? Ooh, it is. It's a thing, and it goes up. Ooh, Torque of Defiance. +10 defense against charmed, confused, and dominated attacks. And +10 concentration. Amulets are most often gems, medallions, or other items worn around the neck. While some serve a purely ornamental purpose, many are imbued with charms and spells to aid the wearer. Torques are stiff rings worn around the neck, like this one. Like amulets, they often have magical properties, like this one. So who should get such an item? Where does it go? Why is that locked? Why can't she wear something there? This goes on the neck area. Like for a cape. She can't wear that. I'm not sure why she can't wear that. Who can wear it? Only usable by Ranger. I didn't see that. Well, our ranger's at home. Although I do plan on bringing her with us when I, dare hold on to it. When we do her quest, I plan on bringing her with us, of course. Okay, so this goes up. Can we sleep here? Crap. Are we going to get attacked? Once we see other people? Let no one know what has happened here. I mean, Aeloth is
keeping an eye out.
Dangerously low. Oh crap. Mm-hmm. Aeloth, just go all the way over there,
yes,
or something.
Laying low.
I got stuck in the doorway again, but it's gonna be another long episode. Amplified thrust off of. No, actually. Yeah, that one. Off of who's in front? Durance? Palagina. I don't know if he's been good to be able to get around these people. Are we not in melee? Oh, because he has this. There we go. Can't even get away. Might as well hit him, Durance. They can't get past him.
Yeah. Run up.
Maybe we can put you to some use. See if we can see here. Yeah. Soul Shock. Off of Canna? Again. Guys are sitting down. Necrotic Lance. On how about that guy? Cast it? I didn't see it.
Hi?
Gaunt's Pledge. You still can't hit anybody.
Yeah.
necrotic lance. Boom.
Yes.
Nice. How much did he hit for? Well, 13? I thought it says for some reason I thought I saw the number 83 flash out there. Hoping we can sleep in here. I don't expect there to be anything that unusual. But you never know, I guess. A lockpick, yay. Can't close the door? Why not? No one's stuck, right? Damn. Huh? Camping not allowed. Alright, guys. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Hopefully we'll get out of here and Aeloth won't be completely slaughtered. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.